Okay, welcome back, everybody, to coffee. It's over across the room. Coffee art in the morning, and we're going to try to do a little bit of coloring in the look. It's been a while. It's actually probably been some months since we colored in this one, and not even sure what I'm going to use. I'll probably use Prismas, and I'm not sure if I want to use Neo color washes, acrylic washes maybe. It's been a while since we've done some acrylic washes. Well, I guess we did some in the Anamorphia. So, yeah. So the look, I'm going to do a little flip here. Thanks everybody for being here. This is a live show on Ustream.tv. So if you're watching on YouTube, this is a live show with a live chat, mostly awake, live audience. And so yeah, hopefully y'all are does it keep trying to no, I don't know. Yeah, could be Dorothy. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and look through the look. This is had this for some months, and what the lookbook is around the world fashion. So it's divided up into it came out in 2015, and it's by Suwa, S-U-W-A, and it's broke out into different countries. So Paris, Antwerp, London, Milan, New York, Stockholm, Shanghai, Tokyo, and Seoul. And so everyone, so here's Paris. So there's probably, you know, I don't know how many, I've forgotten. I probably counted them a while back. How many, let me move the light just a little bit in because we're, it's white paper, it's tricky. So I'm just going to do a kind of a flip real quick. I'm a little zoomed in, so when we go to color, we are a little close. So what I like about this is how close the faces are. You have nice big faces to color, and plus the fashion, you know, you can do them any way you want. And hi, Dot, by the way. I don't know if I said hi to you. Yeah, well, you can't use alcohol-based markers on these because it'll go through. Now, I could make a copy of it, which I can't do now. I'm not going to go downstairs and make a copy. But I have made a couple of copies out of this because I colored some special ones for, I did one for Paula. I did one for Eileen with the water brush. Maybe that's what we'll do. Maybe we'll use some water brush markers that Eileen sent me. I did one for her, and I did print those out and made a special copy for them. But for the most part, I don't like to copy my books. I just like to color directly in them. If they're one-sided, then it doesn't matter if it goes through. But these are double-sided, so you can't use alcohol markers on a double-sided page. Okay, so, yeah. So I'm just going to do a little flip. We'll get to a few that I've colored here. Here's one that I've done. And again, the background is painted with black acrylic paint. And then I think the rest is Prismacolor here. There's some paint on the brick here. There might be a little bit of a wash here and then pencil on top. But for the most part, her clothes, her hair, her bag. There is some silver gel pen on the purse for the metallic. This one of your favorite books? Yeah, I like this book. It's just, you know, we go from book to book and we try to make our rounds. Here's Antwerp. Let's see, did I miss a country? Let me flip through. I think that's all Paris that we just went through. So this one's Antwerp. I'm just doing a quick peruse through. Jean colored this one. This one's London. Some countries have more pages, like Paris had quite a few. Antwerp just had a couple. So hopefully y'all can kind of see just a little. But it's just awesome how close you can get with the faces. Yeah, the one with the dog. Yeah, we'll get to that in a minute. So you can just see like the fuzzy jacket. That's a cool, like that could be like a jean jacket. See the little stitching? We'll zoom in when we get to that point. This one, I've just got the background painted in. That one's really cool. I might do this one because of the close-up faces. I'm liking that for the faces. Although, you know, a lot of people are like, oh, I like all the clothing and stuff. But if you want to use markers, then, you know, copy it off. Now, it's a 12-inch page, I believe, 11 and a half or 12 inches. So, you know, if you print it off, you might not get the full page unless you have a wide format printer or take it somewhere and you have it done. The ones that I've done, a couple, I've just, you know, did like that and cut them out. I did that one too. Hang on, there's Hubster. Just a second, guys. I'll be right back. Hey! Yeah, I just want to tell Hubster I'm still streaming. I'm struggling with the hair to look natural. Yeah, and you know, in different things, whether you're using watercolor markers, your pencils, the different kind of pencils, your markers, your watercolor, your Crayola markers. Now the Crayola markers are great, but they don't blend. Okay, they're not blendable. You're going to try the idea and do a little on each page. Yeah, Elizabeth, that seems to work if you feel like you're not, you know, you work on one page for so long. And sometimes you just get tired of the same page or you want to move on. So my couple of books that I have now, there's a couple in here that are not finished either. But my Imagimorphia and my Anamorphia are the two that I just work here and there, here and there, here and there. And because I would love to finish both those books eventually. Oh, so this one, again, painted the background. And then the rest, this is all pencil. Her moped, or whatever you call it, is not done yet. I still have the metal, the seat here, and some of the metal down here to finish. But you can see she's a redhead there. And I add my own little hairs. You can pull the little hairs out with a gel pen or a Posca pen and then go over them to make it the color by Kimberly. So, yeah, I'm just going to do a quick... Now we're into Stockholm. Again, this is like something I've done a couple of where I've made copies of like her and then colored it on the nicer paper. And you can use markers and stuff and then cut it out and keep it in an art journal. So I've done a few of those like that. If I would have thought about using the markers today, I would have made a copy and done that. But you can't use this. Now we're into New York. You can't use your alcohol markers in this book. It'll go right through. That's where I got the idea of going to try it on the Enchanted Forest. Yeah, to try to get through the whole thing. Yeah. So you can see there's a lot. Now this one right here, this has at least three, maybe four parts recorded. It's at least a year ago. So if you want to see this one done, there's a three or four part video. Again, it's a little there. Let me tilt it a little so you can see the color, because it's like that's flashed out right there. So right there, you can kind of see the color a little bit. So there's a three or four part video on this one. And I've done her on a separate sheet and put it in my journal. I've done her on a separate sheet. I think she might even be in my... Let me get my color book notebook. I might have her in it. On a separate sheet. Let me look at my notebook here, guys. Or she might be in a journal. I don't know. It's hard to remember where you put them. When you cut them out and add them to another page, she might be in a journal somewhere. Let's see. I'm flipping through my binder here. Hmm. Yeah, you know what? I think I'm remembering. Hang on. I think she's in my... She's in my mixed media. Which one? She's in my mixed media color book. I gotta go under the table. Hang on. I'm under the table. Just a second. I think I remember which book she's in. I think she's in this one. If I can get it out. There we go. So I moved my room around. Sorry for the shaking. I moved my room around, and now this table's blocking a shelf over there. And so some of my journals are on that shelf, but I think it's in this one. I think it's in this journal. Because this has got color book pages and mixed media. So, and because I just showed this last week is why I think it's familiar. I think she's in here. There she is. There's that little girl. So here she is, and I cut her out and did a jean jacket. She's got a jean jacket on. Or vest. So yeah, I didn't knock my head. Yeah, thank you. So anyway, there's where we've done her, and it, you know, the lighting wants to change on me, but yeah. So that is her cut out on cardstock and or colored and then cut out. Yeah. Okay, let's keep carrying on here. This is the one I did for Eileen. I did her in green and purple, and I used the water brush markers on her and pencil. The color Quake. And I think this might be the one I did for Paula. I'm not sure. But I've done a few people. You like the freckles? Yeah, I like freckles too, especially if it's a redhead. Okay, so that's all that I've done that's in this book. Like I said, there's probably four or five that are not in the book that I've made copies of and cut out. I love doing color books for multiple purposes. So you can do them. I want to go back to that one, that couple, that guy and that girl, because I think I want to do them. But I like to keep them in the book if I can, you know, and to keep them in the book. I mean, if there's like a whole series like this, if it's my Jasmine Beckett Griffith or my Doodlers Anonymous or any of my Bennett Klein, any of those, the pages are in and of themselves their own thing. So, and they're 8.5 by 11. So I don't mind tearing those out of the book and putting them in my binder. But, you know, something like this won't fit in a binder. So, you know, you can put in a 12 by 12, which I have some of those too. So, where's that page I was thinking about doing here? Let's see. This one. So I'm going to just kind of get the spine flattened out here. So I think we'll do this one. Yeah, I do like using the images for several different projects. So hopefully it looks a little dark. Look at my hands, how dark they are. But I don't want to get it so light that it flashes out. It's just always a struggle. The lighting, the struggle is real. Because you want it bright enough, but then you don't want it to flash out. So let's just do a little play here. Maybe. Because I want it zoomed in enough. I want it zoomed in enough for you to see. Let me do a test in my chat because I've been messing with that. So, hang on, guys. We're going to work it. Where's my shirt here? Let's get a pink card here. Once I start adding some color, it should be better. Alrighty, let's go with that for now. Okay, so I'm thinking I might want to do, I'm trying to decide. Bye, Samurai! Some water brush markers. At least a start. It would be nice to do some alcohol markers on them if I had it printed out. But I think I'll start with the background, and that will be acrylic paint. So let me get a piece of wax paper. Where did I put the wax paper from the other day? Let's see. You guys. I have some wax. Ah, here it is. Because I'm going to go right up to the edge. And you don't want to glue your pages together. Hey, Desiree. All right. What color do I want the background? I do so many black backgrounds. I want to do something different. I could do like a street, like it could be gray. Gray would be good. I'm thinking gray. Looking for my grays. I think I'll do gray and white and kind of make it almost a mottled looking thing. See, I just make this up as I go. All right, so I'm going to put out some gray and white. Let's see what happens here. My water here. And I just use Americana craft paint. Matte, not gloss, not satin. Got to have just the plain Americana so it doesn't, so you can use pencil on top of it. Let's pick a brush. Let's go with this one. All right, so here we go, guys. We're going to start with some background. Almost done swatching the palette. Did you record that, Laura? I don't remember. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to just kind of mix the gray and the white and not mix it, but have it like, so it's like not one flat color. So I'm just going to kind of go. Got to be brave, people. Be brave. See how it looks like marbleized, kind of? Just kind of pat. Just kind of blobbing it on. So it's not one flat color. Let me move my palette over here so maybe y'all can see a little better. I've been swatching them for an hour. You're bored? You should have streamed it. We would have kept you company. We don't mind watching swatching. We don't mind watching swatching. Maybe, you know what I haven't? I don't think I've ever done a whole color book page. Now, some of the tiny details, I couldn't do it all in acrylic. I could, but it would take forever. But I don't know that I've done the bulk of a page in all acrylic. Maybe we'll do that. Let's do some acrylic. I mean, I've done washes on things like in the Anamorphia and all that. Let's just see how much we can get done with some acrylic paint. Let's try that. We'll play with some acrylics today. Of course, they're on the other side of the room. So I'm just going to kind of cross hatch it and make it so it's, see, I don't want, like, see that gray right there? I don't want it to look like it almost outlining him. So, you know, go back in there with a little, you know, something else and kind of, I want it very, pick some of that up, very un-uniform. All kinds of stuff going on back there. Yeah, swatch watch. I remember those swatch watches. I remember Denise. She'll probably get, well, she won't get mad. She doesn't have time to watch my show. But she loved swatch watches. Well, both of the girls did when they were teens. But her whole closet, the inside of her closet, was lined with swatch watch advertising. The whole inside of her closet was a solid swatch watch advertising. See, I'm right up. The reason you want the wax paper is so that you don't glue your pages together, right? So, yeah, we'll see here. We'll just play for a bit. You know, here's how I look at it. And I think Jean does, and probably most of us streamers do, that are at least in our group. If it doesn't turn out, then you learn what not to do at our expense. Right, Jean? Jean might be asleep. I shouldn't be talking to her. She might be napping. So, hey, you get the benefit of us. Am I close enough, guys? Do we need to zoom in more? Are we good? You'll have to let me know. You get to see what not to do sometimes when something doesn't turn out. Can't, you got to be the boss of your color book. That's what we always say here. You have a swatch watch from the 80s. Only swatching happening here. They're probably collector's items now, don't you think, Azure? I mean, I don't have any of them. But I don't think the girls do either. They probably don't have them anymore. Probably get them on eBay or something. I really technically should probably be using a smaller brush, especially right up against their faces and stuff. But I'm just using the pointy edges. This is why I like using, this is a flat, but an angle brush, because you can get in all these little tight spaces with an angle brush. If I had to pick one brush, not napping, okay. And yeah, but how not to do the stoned angel, yeah. And we're talking about a stone angel. Not an angel, that's stone. Jean, how not to do a stone angel. But if I had to have one brush, one paintbrush, it would probably be, and I don't have the exact size here, but it would be an angle brush. It'd be a smaller one than this, but it would be an angle brush like this. Because an angle brush, you can get a wide area, a thin line, and a point, a dot, all in one brush. I'd go one size down from this. If I had to have one brush, it would probably be that. Okay, let's keep moving here. So, does anybody have any weekend plans other than Sherry and Jen? Our friend Jen Oz is traveling the States. And and I want to try to get right in the crack here. I don't care if it gets on the next page. I would rather it make sure to get all the way to the edge. So if it gets on this page, I can always repaint that if I need to. So Jen is going to be in Vegas today with Sherry. And she's been having phone troubles, Jen Oz has, with her phone that she got to travel the country with. And so we haven't been able to have as many updates as we'd like. Still looking like a stone angel at the end, Jean. How do you get the gray and white to look separate? Because I'm not mixing them. I'm picking up a little of both. See, there's two colors on the brush. I'm not blending them in. I'm more dabbing. So they're not mixing. And if they get too mixed, then just pick up, like there's too much gray there, pick up a little white and just tap it on there. See? Oh, Yee! We love Savannah, Yee. We try to make it to Savannah every year, at least once. We don't do it as much as we did when Hupster's mom was alive, because we would take her all the time. We have a lot of family in Savannah. Yeah. When I'm doing something like this, there is quite a bit of paint on my brush. It is pretty thick. Now, when I'm doing the washes, see, this is a background. If I'm going to do a wash on their face, let's say, then it's going to be watered down. You like the filbert brushes for coloring in? Yeah, I like a pointy edge, Denise. I like that pointy edge. Thank you, Ranja. You go about once a month, Yee? Yeah, we don't go that often, but. Okay, so I'm going to just kind of make sure I got everything pretty tight against everything, because I'm going to do more. Let's see, I think that's, there's a little bit right here behind her head. So I'm going to do some washes like on their face and things with some acrylic paint. So we're going to kind of try to stick with as much acrylic as we can. Then we'll shade with color pencil. You head to North Carolina until Monday evening to cabin. Oh, how fun! A dagger brush. Is it the one that has two shapes of hairs, Tar Heel? Like it's got like a center brush and then a few like flickers out on the sides? Oh, y'all have got a lot of fun things. We're not doing anything. We're not doing anything. As far as I know, we're not doing anything. Okay, so you see, now even this, I'm thinking I'm going to want a little bit more gravelly look to it. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of this gray that I've left here and a little bit of black. I'm going to have to jump it up and down. That'll be good for my back. Keep my back stretched out. If y'all weren't here in the first part, my back, anyway. So I'm going to put a little bit of black in that and then a little bit of white. I mean, a little bit of water and make me a splatter. Let me get a soft brush here, a floppy brush, but not too big. I would love a dagger brush. I'm just not sure if that's the same thing I'm thinking of. What's this one called? I got it in my nice brushes. What's this one called? This is the one I'm thinking. It may not be. This is the one I'm thinking of. What's that called? What's that brush called? See, it's got fluffy hairs and it's got a few long hairs on it. This would probably be a good flicking brush. See that? That's what I was thinking of, a dagger brush, but I could be wrong. Holds a lot of paint and you can have two colors side by side. But you can have two colors side by side with any brush. Best going to a garden and patio show in Indy. Okay, so then obviously this is not what we're talking about. Okay, so, but let me show you, it's called, it needs a haircut. No, it came that way. Oh, wait, let me stop here. Let me do this real quick because I got my water in here. Add a little bit, there's a little bit right there. Maybe just a tiny bit more water. But with the flat brush, all right, look. You can take any flat brush and double load it. I'm not getting what y'all are saying because, let me get another color. Just, let's see, let's just go with a purple and a pink. Just to, whoops, just to make my point. So we got some purple. I'll have to get a piece of cardstock out to test. And a little bit of pink. Now I'm going to have to probably go with these colors, you know. That was a Phyllis Diller brush, Whippy. I love that. Okay, wait, come on out there. There we go. Where's my little cards here? Get a test paper. But you can take and get some on one side, some on the other. And have y'all ever seen the fan brush flowers that I've made before? It's been a while since I do those, too. It probably would really mess that up. Yeah, so here's a flat. Okay, so I got half on one and half on the other, purple and pink. But if you can do this. See? You can do a double load. But I'm not sure if that's what you're talking about. The other thing that's fun to do, and again, I probably am not going to remember exactly how to do it. Where's a fan brush? Do I even have a fan brush? I hardly ever use a fan brush. But you can take a fan brush. Okay. It's a sharp angle brush like a blade of a... Okay. Okay. I know what you're talking about now, Tar Heel. I can't say I have one now. I probably had one at some point. But okay, now I know what you're talking about. Okay, so you can take... And let's see if I can remember how to do it. You load one side of a fan brush with one color. You load the other side of the fan brush with another color. Just drag it through. See, like that? Let's put a little more on that side. So you got two colors. Now, I don't remember exactly which one's supposed to be on the top. I don't think it matters. But you have a dark on one side, a light on the other. Then you just smack it down. Okay, it's flat down. Can y'all see that? Then you push up and down and twist. And you can make some pretty cool flowers. Okay, black velvet short handle, blend squirrel. Oh my gosh, she said cut and paste all description. Okay, so I didn't do that very well. Let's try it with the light on the top and the purple on the bottom. Okay, let's try it the other way. So I'm going to smack it down flat. Okay, see how it's completely flat? Then you just kind of push up and back down and do a twist. And you can make some cool flowers. And it does take a little practice. And obviously, I'm not doing it very well. Let's pick up some dark purple and some white. Okay, so there's purple and white. Bye. Hey, Julie Topaz, hi and bye. Oh, you just now got into chat. Thanks for stopping in. All right, so I'm going to push down on the purple, push up, pull down, and twist. See? Isn't that cool? Yeah, it's cool. Now let's try it with the white. Let me get all purple. The white down, then the purple comes up on top. So it depends, you know, whatever color you have on the top, it makes a totally different effect. They're kind of like irises, right? They're kind of like irises, but you never know exactly what you're going to get, you know, even if you practice a lot. Let me do one more here. All right, the purple down. You just smack it straight down. See, the brush is flat. I mean, I pushed it completely flat. Then you just kind of push up and then pull it back down and kind of do a little twist. Yeah. And that's about all I ever use a fan brush for, is these. And I haven't done this just for show and tell here. been watching at work and now able to chat. Oh, now you're able to chat. Okay, well, good, Julie. Good. Yeah, so, you know, and depending on the colors, you know, it makes it cool, whatever color. Let me put this other brush in water so it doesn't harden. Like, oh, here, let me do one more quick one here. Let's do a leaf. Like, we'll do a green. Let's do two greens. Okay. I need another palette. Here. Trust me, I got stacks of these coffee lids. All right, so I'll put a little dark green. That one's almost empty. A little lime green. Okay, now let me clean my brush real good. My fan brush here. Let's get the purple out of it. Okay. So now we're going to do some leaves. Same kind of thing. All right, so let me dry my brush here. All right, so I'm going to get green. Lime green. So see how thick it is? Okay, so now we're going to... This is very thick on here, guys. Very thick. It'll probably take a while to dry. Now I'm going to push down on the dark green and just kind of push it up. See? And then while you're pulling back, you're picking it up. Okay, there's too much water in my brush. There's still water in there. That one's a little better. There we go. See? That kind of cool? I don't know. I never did rose mauling, Scooby. It could be a rose mauling technique. I never did that. I didn't really do a lot of folk art. I did a little tiny bit of folk art, and really I never did any rose mauling. So it could be. It very well could be that technique. Okay, so now let's move this out of the way because I want to do my splatter here. I watered down my black and my gray. Where's that little fluff brush? Where's my fluff brush? Oh, let me get another one here. I don't know what I did with it. I just need just a plain flat. Here we go. This one will work. I just want a little brush that has a little fluff to it. You know, a little softness to it. Your mom did it. It kind of looked like it. Maybe. It could be, Scooby. Very well could be. Okay, so I'm going to get some of this darker gray. Now it's starting to dry out. I need a little bit more water in there. So I'm going to do that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my paper here, and I'm going to kind of hold it up so it doesn't get on the computer. I'm going to try to get a little splatter going here. I want to kind of splatter my background just a little to make it look a little bit like concrete kind of thing. I need a little more water. It's still a little too... There we go. If it gets a little on them, you know, I'll just dry it and, you know, move on. But I'm trying to kind of control the splatters a little bit. And you could always just dot it with the back end of a brush, too. Like in some areas, if you don't want to... Where'd my water go? There it is. I'm trying to be very... See, that's a blob. I don't want a blob. I need to clean it. I want a splatter, not a blob. Back here in the corner. Something like that. And then if I want like a couple of dots, like right in here behind her head, I'll just get a couple on the back end of the brush and just kind of put in a few where... You might think you didn't get enough or something. There we go. There's a bit. Something like that. I want it very rough. Very rough looking. Okay. Now I got to hit this with the heat gun. All right. Let's see if I can move all my palettes. It's a constant shifting. All right. You're going to do a journal page tonight? Laura? Put your link in, Laura. Some of these blobs are kind of thick, so I want to make sure that I get them dry. So, like the granula, yeah, you know, just have it something different, right? You don't have to have it all flat every time. All right, I'm going to move my wax paper for a minute. I might need it again when I don't know. Just, you got to be careful not, when you go off the edge with your paint, I don't care if something like here, look, you can see a little bit of that blue from this page came over on there. I'll just paint over that. But you can glue your pages together. Yes, you're taking Angie's spot tonight, I understand. All right, so let's see. What do I want to do? I think I'll start with the faces. Let me just get a couple shades of some... Because I'm going to just do some washes, some base coat. Here's a... Let's see. It's a... I'm looking here for a couple... Because I don't do much painting on faces. I do mostly color pencil. But here's, now I got one folk art here, but the others are Americana. So let me tell you the colors I got here, and I need another palette. Okay, so what I got here, we're going to roll with this. All right, so I have, this is a folk art, and like I said, I mostly only use acrylic. I mean Americana acrylic. But this has a nice peach, pinky color too, so I'm going to go with it. This one is called Cameo Blush, and I'm not going to need much because I'm going to water this stuff down. And all the colors are probably going to look pretty much the same to you on camera. And then this one is Oyster Beige. Oyster Beige. It's kind of a gray taupe color. And then this one is... Natural Buff. And then I'm probably going to need... Well, I don't need any white yet. Alright, so now let me get a little smaller brush. I need clean water is what I need. I need clean water. Alright, let's get a smaller brush here. Just getting a smaller flat here. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and just spray one spray of water over all of them there. And then I can just kind of pull out, kind of mix that, those colors here, or, you know, have a little water down. Tap it off. Let's water this one down. Tap it off. Let's water this one down. So I got kind of three shades of a creamy color here. Of kind of skin tones, you know. All right, so let's go ahead and let's start with her, and I'm going to take the peachy of the two or the three, and I'm just going to make sure that it's translucent enough that you can still see the color book lines underneath. Okay, and I'm just going to do a wash. And when I say a wash, all I mean is watered down acrylic paint. It's just watered down so that you still see through it. Could do watercolor, same kind of thing with watercolor. And then I'm going to shade with pencil. This will give it tooth. Y'all know I talked about that lots of times, that when you put an acrylic wash, it gives it tooth for the pencils to adhere to, stick to, and make, you know, just, you just have more tooth. It makes it more rough for your pencils to have something to attach to. Okay, let's see here. Let's do her. And this just gives you a nice base so you can start working in shading. Very loose, just a coat, flat coat. right? All right, so for him, I want a little bit of darker. Let me get a little bit of a sienna or a brown. Let's try just a little bit of sienna with the taupe color. Just mix up a little dab. Let's see here. Just a little bit more darker shade. Might need a little bit of water. Let's see, test that out. It's better. Okay, same thing. Just a flat coat of paint. There we go, that's better. This neck could be a little darker anyway, inside his ear. And then a little bit lighter on his face. Going right over the lips and everything. I did get a little splotch of gray on his face when I was splattering. So we'll just see how far we get within our couple hours. Tooth makes it more toothy. Girls. Let's just get a little bit darker, like a little up under his head there. Though I'm going right over his eyebrow. I'll go right over his hair, too. I'll probably make him a brunette. Maybe make her a blonde. I don't know. And the glasses are going to be colored. They're going to be tinted, like purple or something. Okay. His hand. I think that's his thumb right there, I think. Okay. I think that's all the skin I see. And it does warp your paper a little. It's not wrinkling it, but it is warping it a little bit. I just find that if I just kind of roll it back, it's fine. If it gets a little warp to it, doesn't bother me. But, you know, you got to be, if you're one of those people that do not like any kind of warping in their page, then you probably just shouldn't be using any kind of water-soluble anything on your color book pages. You might want to copy it off on a thicker cardstock, you know. All right, so now I got to decide on some colors. I still got staining from the mermaid markers on my hand. Okay, I'm not going to worry about the signs right now. I'm going to just concentrate on them. So let's see. It looks like she has some kind of a tiger kind of print. And her sunglasses have like a leopard design. So do I want to go with an orange? Orange and purple. I think that's what I did, though, with the girl and the dog. Was it? I don't want to do the exact same colors. Orange and blue. Okay, so if I can go with orange and purple. All right, let's see. So we'll get some more colors over here. Orange. Another shade of purple. Maybe a mustard color. So I'm going to have the purple with him, and she's going to have the... Got a little bit of that sienna left, so I'm going to go with that suntan grunge man. A little bit of persimmon, and a tiny bit of antique gold, which is like, it's really not gold at all. It's like an ochre. Just want those three colors. So we're going to start with that. Again, I got to water this down. I think I'm going to start, I'm going to start with the ochre color. I got so many palettes right here in front of me. I'm going to just have a watered down ochre color. If you have any questions, put them in caps. Thanks everybody for joining me. So I'm going to do a full wash over her kind of animal print clothing here. So then what you're going to do all the detail with pencil. I don't know if we'll finish today. I don't know. I hate carrying over the weekend to another part two. Okay, Melody. Sleep well. Thanks for being here. Hope your hand is recovering. Take care of it, okay? All right, so I'm just going to kind of just get a little bit of a, yeah. And then I think I'll take a little of the sienna color and just kind of do a wash right over her glasses there. And I think I'll do ochre lenses on her. Like that. Then her hair, I kind of wanted her a blonde, didn't I? But maybe now that she's all in, going to be in oranges and yellows, I think I'm going to give her purple hair. He's going to be wearing some purple. I'm going to go with some purple hair. So let me come over here and water this down. I've already got some purple here from the flower making. So we're going to give her some purple here. I would so dye my hair this color. My family would disown me. Well, they wouldn't disown me. They just wouldn't be seen with me. Just like I can't wear Wolfie out in public and be walked next to him. I did wear Wolfie during my birthday outing at Blick. But Hubster was across the street taking the picture. Okay, so and I'll do some highlights and stuff in there. A little fray hair stand there like that. Okay, him, I wanted a brunette. So let me get out, where's my dark brown? Let's put out a little touch of dark brown. So you don't need much. I mean, it's the smallest amount for these washes. Right, let's spray it down a little. Get a little water going. So he's going to be a brunette. So I'm going to wash, do a little brunette wash on him. His eyebrows. Hey, Sue. My streaming schedule, it's every Monday and Wednesday at 9 a.m. Eastern, and the occasional Friday, like today. It's the occasional Friday. I almost didn't stream this morning, but I'm squeezing it in, and I need to go run some errands, but I'm hanging out with you guys. Okay, so let's get the top of his hair. I hope I'm staying in camera frame for you guys. I'm really kind of zoomed in so you can see some detail, but that means I got to be aware that I'm got to stay in camera. Okay, so he's got that little gray dot on his face, which I'm just going to take and just a tad and cover that up. I mean, I could cover it up with pencil too, but I want to just kind of get rid of that gray dot. Well, it's going to take a couple coats. Okay, that's what happens when you splatter. Okay, let's see, what else do I want to do next? I kind of wanted his shirt to be a purple. I think I want it to be vivid violet with a touch of maybe the lettering could be dark purple. So I'm going to go with that. There's a little spot left over from the last time I used this color. Okay. Whoa, this is why you need a journal where you smear your paint. When you have leftover paint, when you put way too much out like this, a desk journal where you scrape your paint. So I want his whole, I'm going to do, I got some, it looks almost aubergine now. I got a little bit of black or gray in there. I kind of like it. So I'm just going to make it. See, if you kind of do a watercolory look, then it doesn't look all flat. And when you go to shade on top of it, there's already a base like under it. Okay, so let's just kind of see where this is going. We'll do a little bit of the aubergine eggplant color. And you can use a smaller brush than I'm using here, but see how it looks like not a flat color? It looks like a watercolor wash. So when you go to do, I need more water on that though. When you go to do pencil, and always make sure that your paint is 100% dry. And I know I repeat myself on that, but if it's not, you cannot go over this paint. I'm going to kind of model it up some darker down here. Your pencil will not work Oh, thanks, Dragon. I'm glad to be here. I wasn't sure if I was going to do this second part because my back was hurting, but okay. But we're here. That's part of his shirt or his sweatshirt or whatever kind of behind there. I think that's her hair is purple in there. Where's my purple right here? Let's go back to that purple. Her hair needs to go. There we go. The water's kind of running down over there, so I'm kind of losing some of my water. There we go. So I'm going to just kind of make it grunge, like one of the girls said there. Got a grunge guy. That's kind of what we're rolling with. And I'm going to go over those letters, though. The lettering here, it says Milano. We'll do that in pencil. Or you could do it in your Crayola markers. Maybe we'll do that too. I love doing mixed media color pages, just saying. Now I'm coming up to the edge here. I'm going to try to flick it so I don't stick my pages together. I love doing mixed media color book pages. A little bit more water. Because it just makes it fun to do whatever, you know, use different things, just like you would in your art journal. Okay, liking that. Very grungy. But we're gonna make it work, guys. We'll make it work. All right, let's see now. What else? I need to hurry. His hat. Oh, I want his glasses. I wanted purple. I wanted them a nice purple. Maybe because he's thinking about his girlfriend that has the purple hair. Or he's looking through rose-colored glasses, although they're purple. Is that kind of cool? See, they kind of contrast, complement each other. I just put a purple streak down his neck. Because I'm not... Stop giving him hickeys! Okay, yeah, his hat, I think I want to go, it could almost be white with a purple tint. I think I'm going to do a purple, this is too matchy. A guy, he wouldn't be that matchy, you know? Same for her band here. Now, the girl might be a little matchy, but I almost want to do that in a, I'm looking at my colors here. Do I want to add a green in here? I almost want to add a green. You like that, Jean? I think I will go with here. I got these greens over here left over from. Let me just water these down. Okay, I think I'm going to go with a darker green. Not quite that dark. Let's add a little bit. See, it's starting to dry out and just from that short period of time, separate a little bit. Let's see how that looks. Yeah, we'll go with that. So I'll just go with the two greens here. And we'll do more blending and shading with pencil. I'm just kind of... we like to have fun. I have to run some errands. I need to go. Does anybody know what's on sale at Hobby Lobby this week? I haven't been out of the house in a week. So I don't know what's on sale at Hobby Lobby. But it's right down the street from me. See how much restraint I have? I have a Hobby Lobby literally 3 miles from my house. And I haven't been out of the house in a week. So somebody tell me if there's anything good on sale at Hobby Lobby that we need. Okay, now him, I'm not really worried about the signs right now. Like, that's probably going to be red or, yeah, I don't know. kind of ignoring the signs. I could almost just put a wash of gray over the whole thing and just pick out a couple. I think that's what I'm going to do. Let's water this down. I'm just going to put a light gray wash over the signs. Let's see, I don't want to lose them completely. I've got to water it down just a little more. Very watery. Because I don't want to lose the signs. Oh, it's got a little bit of green in my brush. That's giving it a nice green gray. That's good. I'm just going to kind of make them fade into the background for now. And then we can pick out some color if we want later. Okay. It's kind of like back there. Would even be more broke with a hobby. I know, right? Paper supply. I don't need Pat. I was determined that I was going to do a this week and I didn't do it. Go back again. I've done it before. I did it a couple years ago, maybe. No, maybe a year and a half ago, where I went through all my scrapbook paper. And and got rid of a bunch of it. Worse for me, I have Tuesday morning joints. Well, I have a Michaels, Suzanne, 6 miles from my house, I have a Michaels. I don't have a Joann's next to me. The closest Joann's probably 45 minutes away, so I never get to Joann's. I need some more Americana paint. Yeah. 30% off Americana paint. There you go. All right. So now I just have to decide on his hat. I think I want his glasses to be green. I'm going to pick up kind of a little bit of green. I should probably do this with pencil, not with the wash. But I'm going to just go in. Because I'll brighten it up. I'll brighten it up with pencil. But I want his glasses to be green frames. Green frames. Now, I just got to decide on his hat. I don't want it to be too match. I mean, if I wanted to make it nice and matchy, I could do it an ochre color. That kind of tie it all in. Oh, we'll go for ochre. At least as a base coat. Well, we might add some other, you know, shades on there. You know, because it's going to be a little, whole thing's going to be a little matchy, but it's got a little green in there, so a little bit of green was still in my brush, so. Water down a little. Because it could be like a canvas kind. The hat could be a canvas type of color. Instead of jean, it's like a canvas color. Some assorted art supplies. Oh, Suzanne, 2 miles from the mall. Bless your heart. Frames, I don't need any frames. I don't frame anything. Because all my commissions, people have to frame them themselves. Matte and frame them themselves. Because, you know, that's such a subject, you know, that's such a personal thing. Okay, now let's do a little bit of a gray band. Let's just do a gray band. Whoops. Not too much yellow ochre. Let's just do a touch of gray on his band there. Okay. They're a little color coordinated for my taste, but... All right, so now, see all this extra paint? Now, here's why I want to do this real quick, because I can't say I'm 100% done with the paint, but I'm going to try to be done with the paint. So let me move the paints off my table. Hang on, guys. So I have to have room for the pencils. So let me move all these paints off the table. Because they lay on their side, I really want to make sure all the lids are closed. Because they all lay on their sides in a paint rack. They have their own paint rack. Okay, I'll probably still need some white, maybe some black. I'll leave those two. Okay. So, let's see, all my brushes all clean. Set those aside. All right, so what to do with your leftover paints? Okay, I missed somebody talking about buying something. Oh, Jean was buying something. Did you see last wife? Okay. Miss that, Jean. Miss Jean's shopping excursion. Okay, so what you want to do is I've got all kinds of just journals for, like, here's one that I have different starts of collage bits in. So, like, this one's got a lot of blue. I don't really know that page. Let's just find somewhere where it's more green. Okay, here, this page might be good. So, I have some random collage bits glued down. And see, I'll eventually do something like, where's that page we're just on? Something like this, or something like, you know, pages like this that have a little bit of something. So, what you do is you take a palette knife. And your excess paint, you pick it up and you scrape it on. Really, what should have some wax paper behind here so you don't glue your pages. I'm just going to be a little careful because you don't want to glue your pages together. So you can take your leftover paints and scrape it on a page where you might just have a tiny bit of collage bits. See? And so you're starting another project with your leftover paint. Does that make sense? And this could be a composition book, guys. A cheap composition book, any kind of journal. You know, it could be your mixed media, Dinah, Reevely, you know, any of them. And just scrape off your excess paint and start another page. Okay, so I'm just using up my paint. Now you got to dry this before you turn the page, obviously. But let's just say here's a little bit of brown and sienna, just picking up both those colors. Then you can always go in there with a baby wipe. Do I have one handy? The baby wipe, and you can get in there and kind of just blend out some areas and just get you a page going. I mean, this does interrupt your other project, but this is how you use up your leftover paints and stuff, so you're not wasting anything, right? I'll pick up a little more of the brown and the gold. See, I'm picking up two colors at once. Yeah, composition books. Oh, I got tons of composition books like this kind of stuff in them. But this will give you a nice start for a mixed media page, a collage page. See, look at that already. I mean, I like this already. Let's pick up a little of the black, just a touch there. A little bit of purple got on there. Not sure I'm liking the purple, but I'm going to leave it. Let's go down this side here. So, yeah. But you see, you get the point of it? So I'll just set this aside to dry. Could use a little bit more, maybe lime right in here. There we go. And then you can go back in here and work it. Work it, people. All right. So let's just set this to the side to dry. And with this wax paper, I'll be stepping it on my way out the door. okay. Now, let's go ahead and hit this with the heat gun. Move some of these palettes out of the way that I don't need at the moment. And dry this. You have to have it 100% dry before you start putting pencil. You want this so dry. And dry the backside if you want, you know. Yeah, Jean should probably make some ATC stencils. Good idea, Orla. Did you just think of that, or did someone say it before you and I missed it? So Koi wanted something I could have already in a pan. Oh, y'all are talking about different kind of watercolors now. Okay, I missed half that conversation, guys, while I was playing. I'll have to get some fingernail polish remover to get some of this off. That is a good idea, Orla. Welcome back, Sarah. Well, I'm not near the end, but you haven't missed the end yet. Let me see what the time is. We're an hour in into this part. Okay, so now that it's nice and dry, we can go in here with pencil. And I'm just going to use my Prismas today. I got to move these little flowers somewhere. They're still wet. Jean, did Sherry say if she and Jen are going to stream? Are they going to be able to do something on stream? Or do they have plans to go out and gamble in Vegas or something? You got the idea from Joan. Okay. That's Mindy, right? Is Joan Mindy? I forget. Because I call y'all by your nicknames. So. All right. So let me move all these wet palettes. I got to. Because I'll be the first one to flip one off onto the floor. You should see all the projects going on around here. I should put the camera on the wall so you could see this room. Seriously, oh my gosh. It is a hot mess in here. They didn't say, but they imagine they will be touring. Okay, thanks, Jean. All right, so let's just grab some pencils. I just got my usual silverware tray full of my colors, go-to colors. But trust me, it's not like I don't have any other colors sitting around if I need them. Okay. Maybe we can talk them into the hotel's Wi-Fi. Yeah, Jean. So true. Minky is Joan. Yeah, thank you. I knew it was one of them. Mince, Mindy, or Minky. Thanks. Hi, Joan. Okay, so let's see. I think I'm going to start just because I want to. I want the letters in his... but you know what? I said I was going to also test out maybe just using some of the Crayola bullet tip markers. Let me test this color. So this is what they are. They're the Crayola bullet tip. And what's nice about them, where's my sample little something here? Oh. Is you can get thick, medium, and thin lines with the bullet tip. And I think I left the lid off of this a little bit because it looks a little dried out. Just saying. I might have left the lid off of it. Maybe we can do it. Okay, just a few colors. Yeah, after yesterday, my craft room is getting... Oh, my gosh. You know what I should do? Maybe. Let me look around and see if that would be... I don't know if I want to do that. I was going to say at the end of the show, I'll take the camera off the hangover. You know, the hanging over. And show you what this room looks like. Seriously. Okay, so what I want to do is I want these to be, the lettering just to be a flat, dark purple. Okay? And so I could do that with a nice sharp pencil, but I'm going to just go ahead and try, see what I can do with the purple Crayola. And this won't go through as long as you don't go, you know. After yesterday, your craft room's makeover. He'll be helping. Oh, good. Good, Orla. No more. Yeah, you had a mouse, didn't you? Do I need to zoom in, guys? You tell me. I can zoom in if you think you want to see something closer. Because I know my hand's going to kind of be in the way in areas. Or do you like it at this distance for now? You tell me, because I can zoom in if y'all want. So I'm just kind of going right over the letters. Kind of like, just kind of flicking some letters on here. It doesn't have to be, I just want the idea. And then I think I'm going to do the little stitching around his collar. with the marker too. Again, you can do this with pencil. There's a letter word there. Wait to see what y'all say. Zoom in a little. Okay. Okay, now let me refocus though, guys. Hang on. Where's my Sherry card? This card just always seems to be the best for making it things focus. Not always work, but, you know, let's do the right light again. Okay. Speaking of markers, I have the Crayolas, but I ordered and got to the Stabilo watercolor markers that says it won't dry out for 5 weeks without the cap. Dang, girl. You need that kind of reassurance, Suzanne. I can leave the caps off my markers for 5 weeks, and I'm good. Suzanne, you're funny. But yeah, you have to let us know on the Stabilo. I have the Stabilo. I have a couple of the pens, you know, the fine liners. But I think I gave them all away a year or so ago because I wasn't using them. I said, well, I'm going to give them away. I think I sent them to someone in the UK. I don't remember. I don't remember who I send stuff to, guys. Okay, so there. I'm just doing the little stitching. Of course, you know, it's hard to get in the little crevices here. I'm trying to get as close as I can to the center of the book. And you'll see that. Oh, that does look showing up pretty good. You do need that. Okay, it looks like we're doing pretty good here with the. Of course, I don't look the. I'm look like I have a nice suntan, but the colors are looking pretty good for the. Okay, and I think I might do a little bit of. Lines with the markers. These Crayola bullet tips are called super tips. They're really awesome. They're, you can get a pack of 50. Normal price is $10 at Hobby Lobby or Michael's. But you can use a coupon and get them for like $5 or $6 for 50 colors. And in Canada, I think Amazon CA, I think you can get 100 colors. Now, I don't know how many are duplicated in that. But I just get them at Hobby Lobby. I've got about 3 sets. One color dries out a little. And they last forever, guys. They really last forever. Speaking of markers, I have the color. Oh, okay, that's the same thing. They're just water, kids' watercolor. I mean, water-based markers. I keep don't want to say watercolor. Because they're not water, they won't blend like a watercolor marker, like your Zig Kuratakis or anything like that. They're not going to blend like that. I think I want to do this Milano right here in ochre and do the rest of it in purple just to mix it up a little. Making it up as we go. No duplicates. Walmart also has 100. I haven't seen them at my Walmart in the States, Jean. I've seen the 50 pack. I've not seen a 100 pack in my Walmart. But I don't go every week and check and all that, you know. So that's one of the nice things about using your mixed media in your color books or your journals is you can use one of these, one of those, one of this, one of that. You know, that's the fun part to me about your color books or your mixed media journals. Use some Crayola markers right along next to your Holbies. That's all good to me. When you're, you know, doing mixed media projects or color books. You just have to make sure that whatever you're doing in a color book doesn't bleed through. You know, like you can't use an alcohol marker. Obviously. unless you don't care if it bleeds through, like on a one-sided color book page or something. And then just make sure to put some cardstock or something behind it so it doesn't, if it bleeds through.
They have the 100-pack at Walmart.com. Okay.
All right, Suzanne. Yeah, I've not seen them in the store. I don't think I've ever ordered from Walmart.com. I figured, like, doesn't Walmart already have everything? Do they need a .com? I don't know.
See how fine, though, I can get that down to?
Now, getting in the little crack here is a little tricky here. Little star, there's some little stripes. And we're going to shade some of this, too. Some little stars there. Some more little stitching over in that corner. Okay, now this Milano right here, I want it to be in a ochre color. Let me get my yellows here and do a test. Test paper here. Most of the art supplies are on .com. There's nothing in the store. Okay. Well, I guess because I have a Michaels and a Hobby Lobby, like, right down the street, I don't look for my art supplies at Walmart, you know? Especially when I can use coupons at Hobby Lobby. That's better. But since I'm going over purple, I might want to go with an oranger color because it might turn... Let's see here. I think I'll go with the lightest one. Well, I don't know. I kind of like this color, too. Yeah, okay, I'll go with that one. So hope if somebody's y'all coloring along or arting along or knitting, crocheting, sewing, anything along. Sometimes you can get them cheap. I don't know, Suzanne, can you with a coupon? I don't know. If I could get a better deal at Walmart without a coupon than I could at Hobby Lobby, Michaels, or, you know, I don't go to Joann's, but, you know, Joann's always has coupons. Okay, now I just want a little... See, that's going to get lost in there. Well, I'm going to start. I'm going to put a little bit of this color in the collar, too. Don't really see it very much on the purple, but just a little anyway. Okay, I'm liking that rugged look there. See how it looks cool, all messy? Just drinking coffee and hanging out. Oh, hey, Pat. Good to me. All right, now I'm going to take this same kind of color here, and in her, like, animal print thing, I'm going to do this color. See, I'm trying to... You really probably shouldn't. I mean, it makes it the page cohesive, but when you're doing people in their clothes, I like to do cohesive colors when I'm doing, you know, forest and fantasy and flowers and whatnot. But it can be a little, doesn't look as true when you're doing people matching their clothes like that. Because they probably wouldn't be, you know, they'd probably go out of their way not to match each other, right? But, you know, it's your page. Overall, and you have one coupon at a time in art stores. That's true. Did some collage cards on the first half. Jay-Z, you changed your name again. Why don't you log in, Jay-Z? I mean, you may not be able to. But, yeah. Thanks for telling us who you are, Jay-Z. So I'm just getting in that little tiger. Well, it's not really a tiger. It's not a leopard. I don't know what it is. Animal print design. Coffee standing. Ooh, writing a list of flea markets to go to.
Awesome. Beth, do you have a blog or a YouTube or something, Beth? Not to be confused with beady-eyed Beth. Beady-eyed Beth. Beads. I don't know if she's still here. So, what do you do with your, show your flea market finds and stuff online, or do you YouTube or what, Beth? You forgot to, I haven't eaten breakfast or lunch, Dorothy. It's 1 o'clock. I usually, when I stream, I don't eat till I'm done streaming. But, Kimberly got mad at me the other day she didn't get mad at me. She fussed at me. Oh, you're on your phone at Hobby Lobby? Jay-Z! Oh, my gosh. I'm going there today. What do I need to buy, Jay-Z? I'm waiting also for Beth to say if she has a site or something with her flea market finds. I gotta keep looking at chat because it scrolls by pretty quick. I'm gonna do some skin here in a minute too, guys. I'm gonna do some skin blending with pencil. If I know Eileen is around when I'm at Hobby Lobby, I will tweet because I know Eileen will tell me something to buy. She's not around today. She had an appointment. She may be back. I don't know. But when I go to Hobby Lobby, if I know, and sometimes Jean too. Janet and Jean and Eileen are always gabbing carrying on a polite conversation on Twitter. So I can usually find one of the three of them to talk me into buying something. Those enablers. It's fun when you're shopping to talk to people. Not yet. Thinking about starting a YouTube and streaming, but not ready for that yet. I usually take a picture of what I want to tweet them. And I'll ask, do I follow you on Beth? Do I follow you on Twitter? The brush. All right. So Jay-Z is saying that the brushes are on closeout and deco art. Yeah, we knew about the Americana deco art paint was 30% off. Didn't know about brushes on closeout. Yes. I think you need some stencils. But yeah, well, if I need stencils, Jean, I'll go to you. I don't use my stencils enough. You know? I don't use my stencils, and I need to bust out the Cameo again. Y'all see how many projects we could possibly be doing in a day? I mean, I could make a list right now. I won't stop. I almost stopped to make a list. But there's so many things we could be doing. I really do need to buy some of your stencils, though, Jean. Jean has cut files. If you want to cut your own stencils, Jean has got on her second batch. Maybe it's round three, Jean. Is it round two or round three of doing your files, cutting files? Okay, so now, let's see, I think I might do a little bit of edge on her glasses here. You follow me, Beth? Okay. Tweet me, Beth, so I can know which Beth you are, and I'll follow you back. Yeah, I don't need anything, but you know, I need to get out of the house is what I need to do. All right, let's see. Let's move along to, what else do I want to do? I think his cap. Let's add some of this color to his cap. Again, doing these kind of things, like going from here to here to here with one color, makes the page, a color book page look cohesive. Just like you got the purple. You know, that it'll make your page look cohesive. But when you're doing people like this that are clothed and you get them too matchy, there are days that I get so overwhelmed with going to the craft, I forget to eat. Yeah, Yeah, and that can happen too. I don't use, Pat, when I'm by myself, not streaming, I really don't do that much. I don't go from thing to thing to thing to thing. I'm pretty good about finishing something before I go on to something else. But when I'm streaming something, if I don't finish this, unless I had a purpose for it, like let's say I do need to finish my Bennett Klein page because I want to post it on the Bennett Klein website, right? So I'll probably finish that off camera because I have a purpose. I'm going to post it on the group. But if I'm just doing something here and I don't finish it, if we get back to it or I do a two-part or something, then that's a reason to get back to it. But if I don't get back to this, I just let it go. It's not going anywhere. I mean, look, I got other pages in here I haven't finished. Look, this one I'm not done. There's other pages in here I'm not done with. What did I just drop? Something just rolled off. Was it a pencil? Not marker. So I don't really, except for when I'm streaming, then I go to a lot of different projects. Yes, you know what? I do need a couple of new stickle colors. That's for sure. I think I needed the red. There's a couple colors. Yes, that's true. But Palm also, they don't have all the colors. Michael's is a place to get those, and I don't even care if it's a stickle brand or a Michael brand. Of the Stickles glitter glue, but Michael's always seems to have like bunches of them in like bins on sale. The kind that come in the three packs is usually what you can buy at Hobby Lobby. The three packs, like I have a silver, gold, and a diamond, or a red, green, and gold for Christmas, or I don't see them individually. Don't see them very individual. I used to buy them individually at, archivers. But now it's hard to buy them individually unless you get like, them at Michael's when they just have a big bin of them. Okay, so let's go back up here. So did Jay-Z decide what she's going to buy? Yeah, it does take hours to color with just color pencil. That's why I like to do washes. I love doing washes because you can get a lot done. You feel like you've got somewhere. Oops, sorry. And you can do like these kind of things like this, and then you go in there with your pencil and do the shading. But that's true, Palm. That would be a good buy right there. I will at least look at the stickles when I go to Hobby Lobby. Because, you can use a 40% off coupon on those packs of three. Okay, let's do a little back there. All right. I should just start getting in here with some pencil now, because I said I would. All right, let's just start on him and his. Let's just kind of work our way down. Okay, let's move those markers out of the way for now. See what kind of pencils I might need. Let's start with his hat. So I'm going to get the brown and an ochre color. Those are probably the only two I really need. Where's my pencil sharpener? We lost Jay-Z somewhere in the aisles. We lost her in the Hobby Lobby aisles. Oh, screen is freezing up. We see you. I see you, Teresa. All right, so now I think, no, you know what? I might need one shade lighter than this. Let's go with that color. I think I'm going to go with, for now, I'm going to be pulling colors as I go. So I'm going to pull out the burnt ochre and the yellow ochre for his hat. And I'm going to start doing some shading. And I'm going to kind of do some like textury stuff like this, that like that right there is not really shading. It's, well, it's shading, but it's not for throwing shade. It's to give it some, like, you know, some texture or something in the hat, in the fabric itself, rather than like, here's, rather than a shadow. That's what I should say. But I do think I need to go back to that dark. This was the terracotta, I think. No, wait. Sienna brown. It needs to have a little bit, and that's not even quite dark enough. Well, maybe. I just want a little bit more shading right in there. But this is not like a shadow or shading. I want that just to have some texture. So now when I take my yellow ochre and kind of blend that in, it gives it a little bit more realism. And this is the part, this is my zone out part. This is when I get in the zone. I can color and shade and really do the details. It's always about the detail. Like the same thing with my collage. When I get to the little bits where I'm, you know, painting in little things and stars and planets and all that, that's the fun part for me. Not that the rest isn't fun, but the rest is almost like, you know, pre-detail stuff. Yes, you can use your 60% coupon from Joann's at Michael's. Most Michael's. I should say not everyone, because some of them, they can be a little, you know, a little picky. I find that Joann's is more likely to use a Michael's coupon. Now, I haven't been in a while, so that could have changed, than the other way around. Okay, so like there's the back part of his hat. So glad you colored drawing of your boyfriend. Okay, so now I'm going to go back. And again, I'm just going to kind of give the hat some canvasy texture, like. No particular order, just kind of like so it looks a little maybe indented or a little bit, you know, I was going to say a little bit jacked up, but that probably doesn't sound very good. You know what I mean? It's a little bit a used, well-loved hat. Let's get over here on the side here, too. Okay, Jay-Z's back. 15 Art Deco, 5 Folk Art, 2 airbrush needles, 2 punches for marbles, 4 clearance brushes, damage 82. Did you get the partridge and the pear tree? She only spent, I spent $82, Jay-Z. She signed her name. She's taking credit for that one. Good job there in on the enabling front. Everybody's going, cool, Jay-Z. I don't know if you can see us, our chat, Jay-Z, but everybody's most impressed with your purchases. I'm impressed with the 15 Art Deco paints. I'm sure they're Americana. 2 Folk Art airbrush needles. See, we didn't know that you did airbrush. We need to see more of that now, Jay-Z. 2 punches for marbles. Now, I'm not sure what that entails. And 4 clearance brushes. Okay, so just a little bit, you know, just a little bit of the brown color there. Now, I'm going to go back with the yellow ochre. And again, I'm going to start just kind of blending it in. But I just love doing mixed media on color book pages. Because you can just do whatever. Markers, paint, pencils. All of it. Julie says some of her Bradley's hats are so well loved, they're falling apart. Way more embarrassing than Wolfie! So you will be seen with Bradley in public with those hats. Julie Topaz. So I'm just kind of blending it out a little here and there. Oh, Jay-Z's off the target. We need updates. Sarah got a calligraphy pen with three nibs for $8.99. Ooh, Sarah, I think I saw you tweet that, but I didn't see where you got it. Where did you get that? Don't tell me you got it off of Wish, because I know Janet's the Wish enabler these days. I won't go there. She told, what was it? Who's she tell not to go there? Was it Angie? Don't go, Angie. No. Fall. Come back to the light. Don't go to Wish. I don't know if Janet's still here either. Bring home new hats and toss Owens. He isn't looking. Oh, they notice, though, Julie. You think he doesn't notice if he doesn't have that old beat-up hat? See, that kind of looks kind of cool. It's a little it's a little new on the edge there. Let's see if I can get a little bit more in that stitch line there and a little bit more shading around that little button. You like Wish too much? Is that where you got it, Sarah? Oh, you got a Hobby Lobby. Okay. Okay, I need to do some skin. I need to do some faces. So let's see. Let's do a little bit of his hair first. Let me get a dark brown. Sharpen. Wish is really good. If the purchase does not come in time, they auto give you your money back. But doesn't it always come in time? Okay, his hair now. I'm just going to kind of do some little flicky, like, you know, just flicking in some hair. Here, because I want him to keep dark hair. You'll see that. Hey, Patty. Oh, sorry. Shh. I mean, hello, I-O. Yeah. Well, and you know why you can get it so cheap. It's because China doesn't have to pay the shipping. You know, and I don't know how this works. Something to do with the import-export thing. If we had to send something to China, it cost us, you know, $100. Can you show us how to color the page in jewels? Next time. I can't, but who's the one that just posted on Twitter? Tell me who that person is that's doing the jewels. I can't remember right now. It's not early this morning. I'm going to show it if somebody will tell me. Who posted the jewels? Was it you, Teresa? Because if it's you, you don't need any help with the jewels. Just saying. Whoever's posted this morning coloring jewels, awesome. Jean said they refunded her money because the water brushes didn't come in time. Hey, Button. Marilyn, I like how you spelled that. Button. But they don't have to pay that. So they practically can ship to us for free. Like, they probably can ship to us for free. So if you order something from China, they don't pay any shipping. We have to pay it if we send it anywhere. Like to Canada, for goodness sake. Jean, did you get your color book yet? I sent you and Carrie one of those color books that Angie Bell sent me. I sent you the music one, Jean, and I sent Pixie Carrie. I sent her the yoga one. I don't think it was Scarabs. Who did that? It wasn't Laura. Barb. Yes, that's who it was, Sarah. Barb, I think. Barb Walls. Yeah, let me look it up. Because, oh my gosh, she did awesome. Okay, it wasn't you, Teresa. I think it was Barb. Let me see if I can find her real quick. And I have to find Beth later, too. Yeah. Barb Walls. Yeah. Okay, let me find her here. Tweets. Let me see her media. Was it her? Where is... Yes, here we go. All right, so look at this, guys. It was on the scarab. Yes, it was on the scarab. All right, so let's hope my phone will show it a little bit. So here is what she did. Oh, gosh, I wish it would. These jewels. Look, there. Look how good. This is B Walls, Barb Walls. I don't call her Balls. Barb Walls. Oh, my gosh. Look how good, guys. Look at that jewel. So what I'm saying is, Tar Heel Teresa, you need to get with her. Look how good that jewel is, guys. Okay, then she has a finished one. Wait for it. Then she finished the whole scarab. But I want the jewel. I want y'all to see the jewels. This one's a little fuzzier. There's a good one there. Sent you a tweet, so it shouldn't be hard. Okay, thanks. Thanks, Beth. Look. See? Aren't they awesome? I know. Is she here right now? I'm not sure if Barb is here right now. All right, notifications. Hang on, here we go. Let me look for you. Looking for you, Beth. Ah, there we go. Okay. I found you, Beth. Oh, and you're on Instagram, too. I need to find you on Instagram. Oh, you're so pretty. Can I show your picture, Beth? I got to ask permission before I show people's pictures. You need a demo. Yeah, exactly, Tar Heel. She should give us a demo. Can I show your picture, Beth? I got to wait for permission. But I'll follow you on Instagram, too. The Egyptian Beetle, yeah. Jeweled scarabs are really beautiful. Yeah. Yeah. She did awesome. Barb Walls. Yeah. Is Barb here? Let me see. Scrolling. I don't see. Oh, there she is. Yeah, she's here. Awesome, Barb. I'm here, but I learned it from a lady on YouTube. Well, post a link. We all need to know all this information. You probably tweeted it out and I just didn't catch it. Okay, so yeah, here's our Beth. There's Beth on Twitter. Okay, let's get to coloring. Last chatting, although, you know, that's what we do here. That's how we roll. Okay, so I'm going to flick a few little hairs in his eyebrows. Yeah, if you have the link, Barb, for that, and I know I've seen them on, if you're on Pinterest. Oh, my gosh, there's so many jewels on Pinterest, guys. I should try to find you one, but if Barb finds her link, then that's probably good enough. There you go. I can't go to it right now, Barb, but everybody else can grab it. But also, guys, if you want to find anything, how to color, draw, sketch, anything, you can find it on Pinterest. She does them weekly, and you try to do them every week. What's her name? Because I don't see her name in that link you posted. And I can't go to it right now. Well, me too, Jean. Yeah, nobody wants to see me right now. Oh, my gosh. Oh, Jean. Okay, so, yeah, I'm liking that. Now, let's get a little on his face. Let's get some skin tones out here. Let's get my pencils here. Get this and this and this. And this. That's a little on the, well, that might be good for her lips. And of course, we'll use a little bit of the lighter of those. Maybe we might need a little pink or peach. I've got my, this color. And here's a light color. Do I have that one's the same as that one? We'll go with the short one. Okay, so I've just pulled out some random flesh colors here. Yeah. Yes, you can find everything on Pinterest. It's great for references, ideas, and techniques. Yes, and Julie Topaz. Let me just give y'all a hint. Shh. Don't tell anybody, but Topaz Pearl Girl, if you follow her on Pinterest, oh my gosh, you'll find everything. She's the queen of Pinterest. Shh, don't tell her I told you that. Topaz Pearl Girl. Okay, let's see. Oh, I got to do his glasses. Oh, let's get a light purple and the dark purple. And I need a medium purple. Might have to dig that out some more. Oh, some white. I need a little bit of gray. I need a blue shadow color. Or a slight blue. That's a little too blue. What's my slight blue? You never can find anything? I think you already follow me. I follow you on Instagram, Beth? Okay. It's hard to keep up with where everybody is. We all need, you know, we need a rope, you know. Or drop some popcorn or, you know, leave a trail. Yeah, that's true, Jean. That's true. You can get lost in the world of Pinterest. Okay, let's start with this dark purple here. I needed a medium purple, though. Where's my... A medium lavender. Let me get over to my banded. Where's Laura? I'm going to show her rubber bands. Don't look, Laura. Don't look. I need that medium purple. And it would probably be this one right here. All right, so these two purples. So I'm going to start doing a little shading in his glasses. We're not getting a lot done, are we? I mean, we're not really getting a lot done, I don't think. But hey, we're hanging out. So we're going to make this look, it's going to look like glasses. So we're going to, let's put a little bit of blendy here. Put a nice highlight so it's like he's got a glass, right? Now I'm going to the so they blend in really nice. And if you're new and you haven't, you know, we don't know who you are, feel free to put your, don't be shy, can't be shy. Put your link into your YouTube, your blog, your whatever you do. That way we can, learn who you are. Okay, now I'm going to take my Posca. Where's my white Posca somewhere? And we're going to put a highlight. And then I'll kind of blend out the top of that just so it's not so harsh there. But it might have a little bit of one down here too. Depending on how reflective we give them. right, the green. Where's my couple of lime green? This green and a lime green. Let's sharpen them because I got a tiny little area to work with. And it's probably just a FYI, if you're going to do some colors like right up against the skin, if you're not used to coloring skin with the other bright colors right next, you got to be real careful because you'll pull that green into the face, you know. I mean, that's okay if you want a little reflective light there, but if you, you know, we haven't even done anything on his face yet, any skin color yet. Button says when she wakes up, she has hair sticking straight up. Okay, let's do a little bit on the... And I might, after I do the skin, I might go back in here and do some highlights on the glasses, see, like that. I don't want to lose that, though, if I still have other coloring left to do. But get a little bit extra highlight, like right in here. Right in here. You can add those little touches that make it pop. Probably right on the outer edge here where the sidewalk is, too, if you want that to stand out. But just play with it, because if you don't like it, then you can just, if it's too white or too whatever, then you can go back in here and just cover it up. Now make sure it's dry, because you'll just smear it off if it's still wet. But if it's dry, see, like right there, I just smeared that right off. If it, you know, you got to make sure that it's dry if you want to go back over it. Okay, so I'm going to take my Posca and go right on that little gray where I got the gray on his face when I threw the paint and let that dry. All right, let's pick a few skin colors here. I'm going to want a little bit of sienna, and then let's go with peach. I need my blue-gray because I want a little undertone of blue. That may be too light. Where's my... Ah, here we go. This is what I'm looking for. That slate. I think it's slate. Is TweetDeck still around? I see somebody talking about TweetDeck. I thought TweetDeck went away. I used to have TweetDeck on my other computer. But I didn't, when I got my new computer, I think it was going away or something. So I didn't get TweetDeck. It's a way to keep track of everybody and every, you can have columns of lists. Like you have your art friends in one list, your politics, your news, your whatever. You know, you can have different lists that you can divide everything up in. I don't say it's too much trouble. It was nice when I had it all set up. But then I thought TweetDeck did something and went away. So I never got it on the new computer. Okay, so now what I want to do is I'm going to start with my blue, and I'm going to give him some shadows here. Now, you got to be kind of careful. Don't, you know, especially in a color book. This is more what I would do in a portrait. You know, some skin undertones. It's just for the computers now. Okay, not the iPhone, iPad, effort. Okay, thanks, Jean. But I just use plain old Twitter now. So I'm just, wherever there's some shadow, I'm putting a little bit of blue. It just makes your skin not look so flat. Let's see, there might be a little bit right there. Tarial trees. Oh, Lord, more technology. I don't know how to use. Well, you know, the thing is you hang around us and, you know, you learn all this stuff. And there's some, like, Jeans knows more about Mac. Carrie was like our Ustream iCarry tech. Yeah, me too. I didn't keep it when I got my new laptop, Julie Topaz. And, you know, like Julie's, she's more on Pinterest. There's some of us more on Twitter. Some of us are on Facebook a little bit. You know, there's just, yeah. And you kind of have to find your niche. What color blue is this? I think it's slate blue. Slate blue, Pat. A gray blue. It doesn't have to be slate blue, but it's kind of my favorite blue. Might be a little shadow under his glasses there. I'm just kind of picking it out, you know. Maybe right in here. But you got another thing, you got to do this light, guys. If you start building up your color with hard pressure, there's no blending. You can't blend that blue out if it's hard. You know, if you got lots of layers of blue, you're not going to get rid of that blue. You don't have a cell phone, so you can't use Instagram or Twitter. Yee, yee, yee. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. I can't say that I couldn't survive without my phone. But, you know, and I think that's true with most of us. We're all so used to it. I mean, obviously we would survive. But you know what I mean. It does have a gray cast to it, Pat. You're very observant. It's a blue-gray, yeah. But you have to be careful about building up. You know, because I want to go over this with peach colors. Maybe he has a baby face. He doesn't have much, like, you know, 5 o'clock shadow type. You know, maybe just a little bit of shadow there. So now I think I'm going to go with a little bit of, I don't really want pinky peach. This is, like, I think just called peach. Well, maybe. Let's see. Let me go over the blue. It's so light, guys. I mean, my pressure is so light. Because I don't want to get this too dark, and this might be dark, too dark. It's okay on his neck, because there'll probably be a nice shadow there. But I don't want to get this too dark on his face. All right, so let me get in here with some whites because I don't want to lose my highlights. You like it? Okay, thanks, guys. All right, so now I'm going to get in here with my white. And where I want to make sure I don't lose. And I do this on my tan tone paper when I'm doing my portraits. I always start with white. I pick out all my whites. Now, I'm not starting with the tan tone paper here, obviously. But I don't want to lose my highlights. So I'm going to make sure, and because I'm going over acrylic paint, guys, I mean, I'm going a little bit over some pencil too, but mostly acrylic paint. Remember my demo thing I showed y'all the other, yesterday, whenever day it was, about going over paint versus going over pencil? Where's that little paper? Do I have it sitting around here? I got so many scratch sheets here. I know I had that one somewhere. I was using the back side of it. Where is it? It is one of these Janet things. Oh no, maybe I didn't move around. Didn't think I did, but maybe I did. Hmm. know what I did with it. I showed how going over pencil versus going over acrylic paint and getting the, you know, being able to do that. Because I can always go over this white and tone the white back. But because it's on the acrylic paint, you can get, you know, nice whites. Can you kind of see how it's kind of giving it some shape? Everybody's talking about what they're going to do for St. Pat's Day today. Okay, I do want to blend out some of this. Kind of give it a, not a harsh line, but more of a, just a kind of a glow. I mean a reflection. Okay. I'd be fur broken on Twitter if I broke. Button adequacy. Yeah, you can always do, like, here, let me tell you the story about my Twitter. I'm Inkiwell, okay? I started out online 25, 30 years ago as Inkiwell. But then sometimes Inkiwell would be taken, like on Twitter. Inkiwell was taken. So I had to go with Inkiwell, I-N-K-I, and now that's more, you know, I go by Dede Willingham. That's my, you know, my name. I just go by my name everywhere. But Inkiwell, Inkiwell was taken. So I went with Inkiwell with an I because Inkiwell was taken on Twitter. Well, Pedro, bless his heart, he's Inkiwell. And I think he's in the UK. I forget where he is. But anyway, like, for instance, when we were tweeting last week or the week before, anyway, Survivor, and we were all tweeting together, and he kept, one of the girls accidentally put Inkiwell in my name instead of Inkiwell. And he finally got on and goes, can you please, all you gals, or however he said it, please stop adding me in your conversation. Because every time he would get dinged, right? He'd get dinged every time we were tweeting on Survivor. And he was getting those emails. And so Pedro, and he was a good sport about it. You saw that, Sarah? Yeah. Because he hardly ever tweets. But he has a Twitter. And that's his name. He had it first. Has every right to have it first. So I'm always trying to be very careful not to, we don't want to offend Pedro, who, by the way, we named an octopus, purple octopus after. That's how we first found Pedro, was when we were posting pictures of purple, or maybe it was my blue one. It was either my blue one or Linda's purple one. We were posting pictures of octopus. Yeah, you want it off the chain mail, yeah. Okay, let's do his lips. This is the color I kind of picked for his lips, which was henna. And I'm not going to do it solid like he has lipstick. I just want a little bit in the, you know, color variation on his lips. He won't have as much color definition as like the girl would with lipstick, but he's going to still have a little. So I just want to put a little bit of color on the side, the shadow, you know, a little bit of, in the lips. And then I've already lost the white line. I like a white line on top of the lips, even though if you fade it back out, because that's how people, they, you can see certain white lines real light. When you do enough portraits, you see that stuff. And the same for the lips, but he was not going to have shiny lips like the girl will. Now I'm going to get in here with the peach. Let me sharpen. Sorry, guys, I'm kind of slow going today. You know what I mean? We're not really speeding along, so I hope that's okay. We're getting quite a bit done, but it's not like we're getting massive, you know, massive work done. All right, so now I'm going to go any place I have the blue, and I'm going to go over it with, I think this is light peach. And I'm going to start blending. You'll still see a hint of the blue, but it's not going to be as blue. Again, I'm not bearing down. You can't put a lot of pressure because once the wax builds up, I mean, you can buff some of it out with a tissue and do all kinds. You know, I just try not to get it too waxy buildup because I want to have lots of layers. And if you want lots of layers, you know, because I'm used to doing portraits with pencils, you know, you get it built up and there's no more blending. The brown, you mean for the lips? It's henna. That was henna. It's kind of like a reddish brown. It's got a little bit of red to it. Now, it will look a lot redder if I put more on it and blended it out. I don't want them to have red lips, you know. Okay, so now, right now, all I'm doing is every place I put the blue, I'm kind of going over it with a nice light coat of the light peach. Again, I'm not bearing down. I know I say that over and over and over, and people go, you repeat yourself. I know, because I don't want emails. I couldn't put that color over the blue. It wouldn't go. I'm telling you why. Every time I say bear down, he's like someone's giving birth. Sure. Well, I don't know a better description. What should I say? What's a better way of saying it? Instead of saying bear down, push down? That's going to say that sound the same. You know? Oh my gosh, you girls. Don't bear down. But you see how it's kind of blended it in a little bit? I hope you can tell. It's very subtle, guys. When I do skin is what takes me the longest on anything I do. Whether it's in a color book page with a larger face or, you know, in my portraits. Many, many, I mean, I don't even can tell you how many layers you can end up having on a face, and just build it up. It makes you giggle. Yeah, that's all right. All right. Because I'm just kind of blending out some of the blue, and I have a couple more layers I want to put on. You're still going to see a little bit of it. Especially on a color book page, because I'm starting on a white page rather than a, you know, tan. So, but I think you can see how it blends out. And gives it some shadow. Press. Don't press so hard. Okay. That sounds better, Palm. Now, will I remember that next time? Probably not. Don't press so hard. There we go. All right, now I'm going to go back with the peach. No, I don't really want that peach. I don't want it to get too pink. Let's see. Maybe I want this color, which is beige, I think. What is it? Beige. See, I never look at the names of the colors unless I'm telling you guys. It's beige rose. Beige rose. It's beige. It's not like, see how the difference in the pink, how pink that is? And how grayed out that is? Alright, so now I'm just going to do a little bit more blending. Maybe a little more shadow, like right there under his chin. Maybe a little bit more on his lip. Right on this side of the nose. And you just got to practice, guys. I mean, I'm not going to tell you that you just can pick up a pencil and, you know. And I am following the person's lines. I think he needs a little, where's brown? He needs a little bit darker nostril hole. He needs some dark in that nostril there. Yes, I do my all my portraits on tan tone paper. Pets and people. And if y'all don't, even if I don't follow you, and here's the thing on Facebook, guys, I gotta say, there's so much hacking and all kinds of things on Facebook. I will eventually probably find you and follow you on Facebook, but all my artwork is public. All my Gold Rush, my fan art, my pet portraits, my regular portraits that people have allowed me to post. I always get permission. And all that, all my artwork is public. You don't need to follow me or me follow you to see all my artwork on Facebook. For me to follow you on Facebook, and it's just a time thing, guys. I probably get, and this is probably no exaggeration, 20 a day, 20 requests a day. I probably have hundreds of people that have followed, or, you know, what do you call, request, friend request on Facebook, that I haven't even had a chance to go see who they are. Now, if you are here and I know you here, I will go, and you want me to follow you or follow you on Facebook. And if I haven't yet, and I see you here on in my show all the time, and I haven't followed you, and you want to follow me on Facebook, then message me or tell me or some, you know, get with me, and I'll do my best to find you or follow you. But I literally have hundreds of people. I mean, Denise goes, don't you have some people you need to follow back? I scroll for a look. Look how many people. That I've not followed on Facebook. And so, yeah. But if I know you here, I know who you are, I'll follow you, you know. But, you know, just saying. I don't just follow, just because hundreds of people follow me on Facebook doesn't mean I'm following them back. Because I don't. I mean, why? Because you can see my, if you're a stranger to me and you want to see my art and you want to commission me or something, or you want to see my art before you commission me, you can see all my art without following me or me following you. We don't need to follow each other to see the art. So, I'm just saying that because I don't want to make anybody mad that I'm not following them. But there's just so much crap over there on Facebook, you know. I don't want to do any drama. You're strict on Facebook too, button, yeah. Now on Twitter, I'm more lenient on Twitter. You know, I'll follow. Now sometimes I have had to unfollow a few people. Sometimes people will follow you on Twitter that, you know, they have ulterior motives, and I'll. I know, me too, Dorothy. Exactly, Dorothy. Exactly. So, but it's not that I'm trying to be mean or not, I'm not trying to ignore you or, you know, why isn't Dee Dee following me on Facebook? Well, you know, I'm not following many. I mean, seriously. I mean, I could probably have, you know, 2,000 more followers if I accepted everybody. Just to have followers, though, is not a reason for me to follow people. That's just the way I am. I don't care about the numbers like that. I mean, of course, I want people to follow me here and on YouTube. And, you know, I want a lot of people to see the videos. But I don't care if I have 5,000 followers on Facebook or not. And I really, really don't. So, yeah, don't email me. That's right, Laura. Okay, so I don't want to carry on too much on him because we're not, I mean, I've only got about 20 minutes left. I wanted to leave out of here by 2 or 2 hours and 35 minutes or something like that. But anyway, what I'm saying though, guys, if I know you here, like Vicky S., I think I followed her the other day. But just saw her name roll by. It's not that it's not that I'm not trying to follow anybody. It's just I'm going to see who I'm following first. And, every day I hear somebody say, so-and-so was hacked, so don't follow her. Or she's, getting a new account. And, I don't know. It's just too much work. It's too much work. But, yeah, if I see, say something to me on Twitter and I'll probably follow you. If you just follow me, I get a lot of people that just follow me on Twitter and they don't ever say anything and I don't know who they are. I may or may not follow you, but if I know you, I'll follow you on Twitter. Just like Beth here this morning. I didn't, I followed her right away because I know she's here and all that, but yeah. And like Cindy Lou, now do I follow you on Twitter? Because sometimes people, when they follow you, if they don't comment, and we all have different names. Well, I don't, but, a lot of people have different names. And I don't know who you are. You might be Carol here and Susan on Twitter. Not you, Carol, but, Well, Tar Heel Teresa, here's the thing about your pictures never disappearing online. That's true. But trust me, go Google yourself and look at images. Just saying. Just Google yourself. It's out there, people. You can't hide.
Even if you wanted to.
You're out there. I mean, if somebody wants to find you, they can find your driver's license picture, your passport picture. See, now I put that. I don't like that. Where's my eraser? Where's my electric? I was thinking that would look like the inside of his mouth, but it just looks like he has black teeth. So we got to get rid of that. We don't want him to have black teeth. Now I'm going to go in there with the white and just make it look like that's his teeth. Yeah, but if you... you would think you would not be in there. Trust me, people. You're out there. So anyway, I'm just saying, I'm just stressing the point that it's not that I'm trying to be rude or, oh, Dee Dee's not following me. It's nothing like that at all. It's nothing like that. It is nothing like that at all. So what do y'all think? How's he looking? He could use just a little more dark. I'm going to just go in here with a little sienna, like just under his chin here. I don't want to get too much of the sienna ochre colors in his skin. I'm kind of liking the colors I got. But there's a couple places it needs to be. I could probably should just go with dark brown, lightly. Because I want a little bit shadow areas, but not... I don't really want sienna in there. Well, what I'm saying is, you may not find yourself on just Google, but if anybody wanted to find you, they could. I quit worrying about it. Alright, so now I just added a little bit darker and I want a little bit in this corner. Maybe a little around that nose and a little on this side where the glasses are. I just want a little bit more shadow. I need a little bit more contrast in a couple spots. Not too much though. And then I'll blend those out. Yeah, Palm, but, well, you can limit it, but trust me, it does a little, and it does a little for a while, but if you're online, yeah, and I've been online for almost 30 years, 25, Between 25 and 30. Me and Carrie go back to Merck. And then some of the girls go back to, what's the one before that? Some of y'all know. Yeah. I don't know. I guess I like talking to you guys. So for me, and it depends, you know, some people love Instagram. I post my art pictures there, and that's pretty much all I post. I post occasional picture over on Instagram, but I try to keep Instagram pretty much art. And I pretty much follow, of course, most of my friends online these days. I have a few others that I'll follow in other venue or other platforms. But for the most, for me, my Instagram is all art. Facebook, I'll talk to my family here and there. But I talk to my family on the phone. You know, we don't talk much online because we talk. And Twitter is where I chat with everybody. Ice Chat was like kind of like Merck. Julie, I'm thinking of, there's another, what was the one? It was before that. Oh, it's not coming to me. It's been so long. What was I going to say? For talking with you guys, it's here on Ustream or Twitter. That's just my preferred place to do my chattiness. Okay, so now I got a little bit shadows here and there, extra. So now I want to blend those out with a nice light color. Yeah. But what was it? It was a chat program back before IRC that I'm trying to think of. I'm not thinking of it right now. And IRC is probably, well, I know I'm not on it anymore. But I still have an account there for like 30 years. I'm not talking about the messenger like ICQ. That's a messenger system. But I'm not talking about, like through Yahoo and stuff. Hey, Debbie. Debbie says, Debbie can't follow along on Twitter. She's a dork. You just don't do it enough, Debbie. That's why. If you did it more, you would be able to. No, I'm not talking about a messenger thing like Yahoo and ICQ. There was another, I'm thinking of another platform. Somebody will probably message me. Somebody will comment on it. I'm talking way back. Yeah, I never did MySpace. I guess because by the time MySpace was around, I was on IRC, so I didn't need it. Wouldn't want my partners. I know you wouldn't, Palm, but you know, I can't say that there's nothing private anymore, but really, guys, I won't get into that right now. Okay, I think I blended out his face. But do you see how many layers I added? Did you see all these layers that I've added in the last 30 minutes to his face? And the reason you can do that is because I'm not pressing down. Kim, yeah. Twitter to me. And Carrie's the one that got me on Twitter. You need a Twitter tutorial? Just start talking to us, Debbie, and it's really not that hard. To me, I gotta say, guys, this is just my personal opinion. Twitter is the easiest. Well, other than Instagram, you just post pictures. That's what all I do. I'm not a chatty person on Instagram. To me, Twitter is the easiest to chat on of anything. Facebook, it used to be better on Facebook where you could see everything everybody, all your friends said. It would just scroll sequentially. But now Facebook is like, you can see whatever. Like if I talk to Debbie 3 times a week on Facebook, everything she says pops up in my feed. When I go on the Facebook, I'll see Debbie right there. Even if I haven't talked to her in 2 days, if I've talked to her 3 times in a week, there she is. But if I don't talk to her for a week, I got to go find Debbie. I got to go scroll and find Debbie or put in the search. For instance, because I just see Debbie here, so I'm using her as an example. It doesn't go sequential anymore, Facebook. Twitter is, it's still to me, it's kind of getting a little worse, but it's still, you can follow every tweet. If you're willing to scroll back. Yeah, Debbie, be afraid, very afraid. Debbie and I, well, we have our own little thing, but Debbie and I can have a sticker war in a heartbeat. Anyway, what I was going to say, though, is, I forgot what I was going to say. Debbie distracted me. if you're willing to scroll back in your Twitter feed, you can find every tweet. Facebook, you can scroll back in Facebook and there's stuff not there. You can lose things in Facebook. But in Twitter, as long as you're willing to keep scrolling and scrolling and scrolling, it's there somewhere, you know? Now, for me on Twitter, and I've said it a couple times, I don't see every tweet unless somebody actually puts in Inky. Don't forget that I in Inkiwell, or Pedro will be coming after you. Because I'm not Inkwell on Twitter. I'm Inkiwell with an I. but if you don't put the person's name, yes, Debbie, you can scroll back. But if you don't put a person's name, I need to show you how then, Debbie. But if you don't put the person's name, let's just say Jean and Janet and Eileen were talking. And they're talking amongst themselves. And if I want to say, oh, is Jean going to stream tomorrow? I wonder if she told Eileen she's going to stream. I could put in Jean's name and go scroll through every tweet Jean put in. But if she didn't put my name, I'm not going to be attached to that conversation. So I would have to personally go look up Jean and see what she said about streaming the next day. If it was just a general tweet to everybody. If she put my name in it, Inkiwell, and Eileen and Jean or whoever, then we're all connected to that tweet. But because I have I just follow a lot of talkers. My Twitter feed literally never stops. 24 hours a day, there's somebody tweeting in my feed. It never stops. Tweet, 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 tweet. So if I want to see what Jean said, I'll go find Jean. I won't go scroll back till 8 hours ago in the middle of the night. So I stopped scrolling back overnight because it was taking me 1 to 2 hours. No joke. 1 to 2 hours to scroll back through all my tweets overnight. So I stopped doing that. So if you just did a general tweet, like if Jean just tweeted, I'm going to stream tomorrow and didn't connect my name, then I won't see it unless I go look up Jean. But I will. Yeah, I'll look up Jean and Bob. You know, there's a people that I'll go look up that we talk all the time, right? We talk all the time. But let's just say, and if you don't put my name, okay, here's another example. And I don't know how I got off in this, just kind of talking social media. Let's say, and I came across, I think it was might have been Barb W. here, Barb Wall. I think I just happened to come across because somebody else connected me to it. She put, Dee Dee, look at this picture. And it may not have been Barb. It could have been it could be anybody. This happens a lot. They'll say, Dee Dee, what do you think of this picture? They didn't put at Inkiwell. They just put my name. That doesn't connect me to you. Just putting in my name will not connect that tweet to me. You have to put at Inkiwell. Or I have to put at Music Scrap Jean. I can't just type in Jean. Jean won't see it because I didn't connect her with the at sign. So if you want to make sure somebody sees your art or your information, or you're wanting to say, Dee Dee, are you going to stream tomorrow? Don't just put Dee Dee. Are you going to stream? I won't see it. Yeah, Dee Dee, Jean has 133,000 tweets. I'm not sure what I'm up to, Jean. It's probably not far behind Jean. Jean and I are talkers. But what I'm saying is that's one of the things that you have to know about Twitter. I'll tell you two things you need to know about Twitter. One is you have to put the at sign and the person's nickname, whatever they're signed in as. For me, it's inkiwell. Or your chances are I won't see it. Or if you don't put at music scrap, Jean won't see it. Or if you don't put Janet at J Merle, Janet won't see it. That sort of thing. Okay? That's one thing. The second thing you gotta learn real, real fast for newbies on Twitter. And I know we have some, I don't know if they're here, but some people that are new on Twitter. If somebody doesn't talk to you on Twitter, you can almost assume they did not see your tweet. Never assume they're ignoring you. Never assume that they're just dissing you or ignoring you. I can almost guarantee you that the people did not see your tweet. And people's feelings get hurt. I've seen it over and over and over. Why aren't you talking to me? Why isn't anybody talking to me? I'm leaving. Nobody talks to me. Newbies on Twitter, they say that all the time, and I see it all the time. And if I catch it, I'll try to comment to that person. We probably just didn't see you, especially if you're not using the at symbols, at music scrap, at inkiwell. We probably didn't see your tweet. Yeah, Debbie, all the pressure. So those are just a couple things I would say, at least about Twitter, which is where I'm at most of the time. Okay, we're not getting very far. Let me go here on my shirt here, and I'm going to take the light purple. Yeah. They get their feelings hurt because nobody's talking to them. And I think some of it is they don't know how it works. You have to put an at sign if you want to talk to somebody. You can't just say, oh, Dee Dee, look at this. Especially if it rolled off overnight. It's gone, baby. I ain't rolling back 2 hours. Yeah. Yes, you have to use the at symbol, Debbie. Now, if you don't put the at symbol, here's what happens. Everybody that you follow and follows you will see, if they're willing to scroll back in their feed, they'll see that tweet if they go back hours and hours and hours. But like Debbie, if you want to talk to me, you have to put the at inkiwell. If you want to talk to Jean, you have to put the at music, you know, you have to. No wonder I've been ignoring you. See? Exactly. That's my point. Debbie.
There's my point. And I didn't even know that you tried to talk to me, Debbie. But, you know, that is, she might be half kidding too, Debbie. You don't ever know with her. But anyway, yeah, you have to put the at sign. So there's for the newbies that are watching here or just the recording or in general. Yeah, if you want to talk to somebody, you got to put the at sign. If you want to talk to everybody, Debbie, you don't have to put the at sign. And everybody following you can see you. But will they see you is another thing. Because if your feed rolls back, you know, it scrolls. You know, people get more and more and more tweets. So yours goes down, down, down in the past. Okay? So if you tweeted 6 hours ago, unless I scroll back 6 hours, I'm not going to see that tweet. Unless I want to keep up with you personally, like I might Jean or Janet or, you know, Carrie or somebody like that that we've tweeted for years, then I'll put their name in and go look for that person. Yeah. See? Yeah. So, yeah. I hope that kind of makes sense.
All right, so I'm just going to kind of put a little bit more lavender here and there. Kind of mess up his little sweater a little bit. Or some, like maybe around his hands where it's not quite enough paint from earlier.
And we're about to run out of time here anyway, guys. We probably have about 5-10 minutes before my time is going to be up. Yes. No, Beth. Beth, look at that, what you just put in there. Beth, put the I. It's Inkiwell. Inky with an I. I'm going to correct that right off because you're going to get Pedro mad.
If Pedro comes up and starts cussing you and using the F word, don't blame me if you didn't put in that I.
Oh, and you know, if you're not following, you know, I'm not following hundreds of,
I don't have thousands and thousands of followers because I don't follow thousands and thousands of people.
I follow maybe 2,000. I'm not sure. Let me look. Okay, so I'm going to go to me. And if my phone wouldn't flash out, I'd show you a couple tips. Okay, I am following 1,777 people. I have 1,932 followers. And those 1,900 people talk a lot. A whole lot. So I'm not sure. I don't know if I'm sure there's a way probably to see it on my phone, but I'm not sure how many tweets. But I think me and Jean's got me beat by how many tweets. But anyway, they just changed something on Twitter, and I don't know if I can show this. It might show. Now when you go into yourself or anybody, it used to just be tweets, media, and likes. And they've changed it a few times. Now there's a new column. Tweets, tweets and replies, media and likes. So if you want to see every tweet you've been involved in, you need to click tweets and replies, Debbie. Don't just go to tweets. Go to tweets and replies. And it's probably not showing up very well here. Okay? When you put the at sign, Barb, you have to put at Inkiwell with an I. Don't just say, hey, Dee Dee, I won't see it. You have to put the ads or anybody you want to talk to. If you want to make sure somebody sees you, you have to put the at sign. They can still see you if you just generally tweet. Like when I put coffee and art in the morning. Here, this is the tweet I did before I started streaming. No at sign. This goes out to everybody, okay? This goes out to everybody. But let's say Jean. Unless Jean scrolled back in her feed, she would not see this tweet. Now, if Jean scrolled back, because Jean and I follow each other, she would see that. But just, you know, if you have hundreds and hundreds of tweets and you have to scroll back for hours, you're not going to see that. Okay? Because there's no at Jean. If I want to put, you know, if I want Jean to know I'm streaming, then I need at Jean in here somewhere. It doesn't have to be at the beginning. If I only want Jean to, well, I can't say that. See, I don't want to confuse anybody. If I'm tweeting to Jean, I want Jean, this tweets to Jean. Let's say I said, Jean, I want you to know I'm going to stream coffee and art in the morning. I'd put at Jean, you know, at Music Scrap. Okay, at the beginning. And then anybody that followed me and Jean can also see that. But they have to scroll back. Yeah, you have to be a scroller, Debbie. You have to be a scroller. Karen. Yeah, but the more you do it, the more you have to do it, though. It's like, to me, it's like anything else. You have to get in there and do it. Just get in there and do it. Is there a way to prioritize who you want to see at the top of your feed? I don't think so on Twitter. That's kind of how Facebook. You can do some prioritization on Facebook, Debbie. But as far as I know, Twitter is more sequential. So it's just whoever's tweeting. It goes by time. Yeah, exactly, Aroma. It's sequential by time. Okay,
Why, did you just tweet me? See, I have no notifications right now, Debbie. If you would have tweeted me while we're here, I would have that in my notification. So I could click my notification. See, y'all look, pay attention to this stuff, people. Okay? So I click my notification, and here's where Elizabeth just followed me. Okay? That was the last thing that somebody personally talked to me. Now, do I have tweets? Oh, yeah. I've got hundreds of tweets since I've been here. From 5 hours ago, I could probably scroll this for 15 minutes. That's no lie. But nobody has added me. At. Okay, I know that's... If you're watching this on YouTube, don't email me. I know. Okay, so I think what I want to do, guys, maybe we'll finish this on Monday. What do y'all think? Should we save this for Monday and finish it? Because we didn't get that far, really. I mean, we did get him and the hat and the sweater, although I'm still kind of, roughing up his sweater here. Yeah, but the thing on Facebook, Debbie, is even though if you... prioritize, you can still get things still get lost, especially if you don't follow that person a lot. Like, for instance, Jean. I rarely see anything from Jean on Facebook. Rarely. Now, I can put in her name and look at everything. Okay. See, somebody just tweeted me. Was that you, Debbie? I'm going to go look. Okay. So I got a notification on Twitter. Let's see who that was. I bet you it's Debbie. Oh, it's Julie Topaz. So what Julie Topaz did is she just added me and you. So you should have a notification too, Debbie, from Julie. Okay? She added both of us. Now everybody's gonna be, you guys, now y'all are gonna start, right? Y'all are all gonna start. Bye, Sarah. See? I have my sound tweet notifications. I have them turned off on my phone. So what you're hearing is my iPad. My iPad tweets, my sound is on Twitter sound when I get a notification on my iPad. I don't have any kind of those notifications on my phone turned on because I don't want sounds on my phone. You know, so you can turn the sounds off. They are turned off on my phone. Well, okay, thanks guys. I hope it was a little bit of a little Twitter demo or talk or whatever. So yeah. And I'm just touch the surface. I mean, there's more to, you know, especially if you want to post pictures or, you know, there's all kinds of things you can do on Twitter. Did yours come through? No, Debbie. No. Caroline, Laura, okay, unless that's you right there. No, there's Jean. Yours has not come through. Let me go to you, Debbie. I'll put you in. I'll go find you. Let's see what you're doing, Debbie. I'm going to go see what you're doing over there. Let me see what you're doing wrong. Okay, tweets and replies. The last tweet I see that has me attached to it, Debbie, is a day ago. So, I don't know what you did. That's the last tweet. And before that, you tweeted Barb 5 days ago. You're welcome, DeMonte. Oh, my goodness. I'm waiting for you to do something here, Debbie. Now, somebody else just tweeted me. Hang on. There's Laura saying hi. Hi, Laura. Yeah. And Laura, by the way, Petro's going to hit the roof. Yeah. Do not put Inkwell. It's Inkiwell. I don't know. Anyway, but I looked at Debbie. She's not doing something right there. what was I going to say? Oh, Laura. Laura's now on Instagram. So if you're on Instagram, Laura is now on Instagram. I followed her over there. See, y'all aren't going to stop now, right?
Oh, there you are, Debbie! Yay! Boo! Boo, Debbie! Bye, Tario. We're getting ready to leave, by the way, guys. I'm fiddling in now. We're just chatting and fiddling. So the girls are just having fun now. You're also an Instagram dork, too. Okay.
Oh, my gosh.
Okay, so we'll finish this on Monday, guys. Because, obviously, people want to talk to me on Twitter. But, really, guys, we're all willing to help each other. I mean, if you need help with any of it, just let us know. We'll do our best. You know, we'll do our best. Yeah, Debbie. Debbie, have you tweeted 6 times now in 5 years? You like these days, DeMonte? Thank you. Miss Aroma goes, thank you. Not a teacher, Dee Dee. I'm not a teacher. Seriously. Look how much I rambled. Jean probably could have. Listen, Jean's a teacher. She probably could have got all that Twitter information out that I just spent an hour. Jean probably could have done it in 140 characters. Because Jean's a teacher. I do have a recording of a Magimorphia background day, DeMonte. It's in my color book playlist. Okay, guys. I'm going to let y'all go. Because you're going to drive me crazy now. Just send a tweet. We'll help you. Yes, Jean. All right, I'll make sure and keep all my same colors and everything. We'll finish this page on Monday. And we're also got Trina mail. Trina sent some cards and happy mail. We'll show that on Monday as well. Okay. Y'all have a great weekend, guys. We'll see you. Laura's streaming tonight in place of Angie at 7. We all see each other because we are on Twitter. Bye, guys. Bye, guys.